Hello. If you don't know us already, my name is Seth Russell and this is my wife, Chelsea. We are professional classical musicians. I play cello and she plays oboe. And yes, sometimes we play them together at the same time. You may have seen my first video in this new cello vlog series where I just talked about how I started as a cellist, things I've done so far in my career, and what I'm doing now in my career in an attempt to further demystify the lives of classical musicians. I decided to collect a bunch of classical musician frequently asked questions. So this compilation of questions is some questions that I receive a lot, some that Chelsea receives a lot, and I also got questions from musicians on Instagram and on Facebook. So here we go, classical musician frequently asked questions. So if I'm walking around with my cello, probably the number one question.
Is that a guitar?
It's not a guitar. And I usually give people a break on this because they're kind of similar sizes, except that the shape is pretty different. And like, it would be a big guitar based on the case. It's not a guitar.
Is that a bass?
It's not a bass. Again, size is pretty different. Also, most bass players can't or don't carry their bass on their back.
What?
Question?
Nope. Well, if I'm telling somebody what I play, and I say, well, I play the oboe, they're either like, what? I have to follow up, I'm like, do you know what an oboe is? It's a lot like a clarinet, sounds way better, in my opinion, but that's usually the question I get, is that a clarinet?
What's the best way to discern if one is looking at a clarinet or an oboe?
If there is a tiny little reed sticking out at the top of it, there's a good chance it's an oboe.
If the player has a lot of knives on them, it's an oboe player. Because they scrape them on their reeds.
That's another question I get. Do you make your own reeds? Which, yes, I do. It's basically like you are carving or whittling a tiny little piece of wood using all sorts of crazy tools. Basically, I have to create my instrument on a weekly, daily basis.
Another question that I've received several times, I think from well-meaning people, they see me with a cello and they say, oh, do you play that? And then their follow-up question is, well, like, are you good? Yeah, I'm sure it's well-meaning, but so I imagine, you know, meeting someone and they are carrying a briefcase. And I'm like, oh, is that your briefcase? And they're like, yeah, this is my briefcase. I'm a lawyer. Like, oh, you're a lawyer. Well, like, are you a good lawyer? This is exactly the same in my mind, except that I know being a cellist is a little more unusual than being a lawyer, but kind of the same scenario. So don't ask people if they're good. Just don't ask them. Since my instrument is bulky, people often ask me if it's heavy to carry or if I know exactly how many pounds it is. The answer is it's not that heavy. Cellos are hollow. So it's more just awkward, bulky. It's not super heavy. Especially if you have a lighter weight case. Back in the day, they would have wooden cases, and those things are incredibly heavy.
I have a question for you.
Yeah, is it about what I'm carrying?
About what you're carrying on your back.
Yeah.
Do you have a dead body in there?
For a while, I thought it was unique. Like, I got one person asked me that, like a stranger. I was like, well, that was really weird. And then another time, another stranger asked me that exact same question. And on a cello forum, super nerdy, on Facebook, several people said they got asked the same question before. So, I don't know why. I don't think I want to know why.
It, like, mildly resembles a shape of a body.
Yeah. At one point, I think in high school, me and my cello friends discovered a movie poster for a Japanese horror film involving a cellist. So maybe that happens in that movie. Following this line of interesting questions, they see me with a cello and everyone thinks it's really clever to say,
Don't you wish you played the flute instead?
So many people. This was by far the top question that other cellists gave me on the nerdy cello forum. The answer is no. I don't wish I played the flute. Flute's great, but I like cello. And I don't know why people just assume flute. I guess because it's light and you can take it apart. It's much more portable, that's true. Yeah, but no, I don't. I've had people ask me, and other cellists as well, have had this question, can you play that one song? Or can you play the Yo-Yo Ma song? Or can you play the Piano Guy song? And what they mean is this song. Which is Bach Suite number 1, The Prelude. Made famous, I think, by Yo-Yo Ma, and the Piano Guys have their own version. And yes, I can play.
Yes, you can.
When people discover that you play the oboe, or a wind instrument in general, is there a go-to song they're like, oh, can you play?
Gabriel's Oboe.
Gabriel's Oboe.
Snake Charmer song.
Is that just a generic, just a generic song?
The Duck from Piano Love.
Oh, that's a classic. In conversation with people when they discover I'm a cellist, they often get excited and say, have you heard these guys? And I have heard of them.
Since you can play cello, can you play violin or bass too?
No, I can't, nor viola, though they don't usually ask about viola. A lot of people will assume that if you play cello, you can easily pick up bass, and that is not the case. Bass is a totally different instrument. It has totally different strings, and actually violin, viola, cello are tuned in fifths. Bass is often tuned in fourths. So the relationships between the strings are totally different. And the spacing is way farther on a bass. Though I do know people who've successfully learned cello and bass. I had several cello students at one point who were taking bass because they were required to take another instrument at the school. And actually at UT, there was a bass professor who apparently was also very good at cello. So it does happen, but I can't do it. So you play oboe. Well, how many other instruments do you play?
That's my instrument. I play 1.5 instruments because I play a little bit of piano, but...
Half a piano.
It takes pretty much all of my efforts to try to play one instrument well. How about you? How many instruments do you play?
I would say I play 2. Sometimes I say I just play 1 because it's simpler that way. But this is also a common question that musicians will get, classical musicians will get. And I think it's very, very common for classical musicians to focus in on one instrument, and that's their thing. And in my mind, like, cello is plenty to deal with. That's plenty. Can't really handle anything else. I did play a little piano growing up. You have to use a little bit of piano in music school. And I play the mandocello, which is like the cello version of a mandolin. So that's pretty much it. I don't consider myself a pianist at all, but I do play cello and mandocello. And you play oboe and piano. So you play the oboe. Well, like, how much does your instrument cost?
Just not a question you should ask.
It's kind of personal. Again, like, I know people are just like curious when they ask this question, and the answers can be interesting, but it's a little bit personal because even musician to musician, I would be cautious asking someone else what their instrument costs unless I was pretty close with them. Just because people can kind of get insecure about if they feel like they have a cheaper instrument compared to the person that's asking, or if they have a really expensive instrument and they don't want people to know that they have a really expensive instrument. You just never know. For cellos, they can really range to the sky. Like, you can get a student full-size cello for a few $100s, or if you are bidding on a Stradivarius, should it be up for auction, you might be laying down $6 to $8 million. So everything in between, you can pay for a cello. I would say it's not uncommon for a professional in an orchestra to be playing on a $20,000 or $25,000 instrument.
Unfortunately, wind instruments don't appreciate like string instruments do. So oboes have to buy new oboes every few years, whereas hopefully a string player settles on one that they can play for life.
Yeah, that's true. And yeah, like she said, if the stringed instrument is well made, it will appreciate in value. When I'm traveling with my instrument, I'm easy to spot because I'm the guy carrying around a cello through the airport. And coming onto the plane with the cello, which always makes the flight attendants a little bit nervous if I'm not quick to explain that I've bought a seat for it, then at least five more people during the flight will ask me, do you have a seat for that? Do you have a ticket for it? And I realize that one isn't unusual, but a lot of cellists will buy a seat for their cello. So you sit right next to it, has its own ticket, and that's because they can just get demolished under the plane. I used to fly with mine a long time ago under the plane in a special giant flight case, and one time they lost it, another time it still broke inside the case, inside the flight case. So after that, it's decided it was basically ongoing insurance to buy a seat for it. Do you ever have a problem flying with an oboe?
Only if I forget to put my reed knives in my suitcase. I have accidentally had my reed making knives in my carry-on before, and it's not a good position to be in.
Don't bring knives on the plane.
Hey Seth.
Yeah?
Do you have perfect pitch?
You know what? I don't.
I don't either.
Although I think, sometimes I feel like you're closer to having perfect pitch than I do.
Isn't it like either you have it or you don't?
I'm not sure. There's been interesting studies on perfect pitch. Some people call it absolute pitch. Not every musician by any means has perfect pitch. Perfect pitch is just the ability to hear any pitch and be able to name it. So your brain has made a connection between the sound and what we call it in a scale. Chelsea and I both have what we call relative pitch, where you hear a pitch, and if someone tells you that pitch is an A, or if you can quickly figure out it's an A, from that pitch you can easily figure out a D, or an F sharp, or C sharp. How many hours a day do you practice? Yeah, musicians don't usually like that question, but it's another common question. And I get it. I get the thought behind that, because practicing is a huge part of what we do as musicians. If you're an audience member, you see us on stage at certain times, but we're practicing all the time. That's our day-to-day. So it really depends. It's kind of like asking about the cost of an instrument. I don't really want to tell you how many hours a day we practice, because we might get judged by another musician or judged by ourselves. But I think it depends on the person. It depends on the instrument they play. For instance, string players can normally practice more hours in a day and longer at a time than like a vocalist or probably a wind or brass player, would you say? Just because different physical demands. We don't have to use our mouths or our lungs in the same way. In high school, after I went to a summer festival where we had to reach, as part of the structure of the festival, we had to do 4 hours a day. After that, it kind of got me in gear to have that as a goal, even during the school year, 4 hours a day. I doubt I got that every day during the school year because of schedule, but I think it helped me prepare for college auditions. And then, you know, in school, mostly I just remember trying to practice as much as I could fit in around orchestra and rehearsals and classes and homework and all that stuff. Some people will ask me, do you still have to practice very much? And my answer is yes. Some people might assume that I've been playing cello since I was young, you've been playing piano and oboe since you were young, we've been to music school, we've had all this time to learn and practice, so maybe we're good now. Unfortunately, that's not the case. It's an ongoing, lifelong pursuit. There's a quote from, I think it's Casals, where he was like in his 90s, And someone asked him why he still practiced. And he said, because I think I'm starting to improve. It's pretty accurate. It's a lifelong pursuit. It's a lot like being an athlete, maybe, where you have to stay in shape. So if you stop practicing, you will not be in shape to play your instrument. Okay, well, that was at least some musician frequently asked questions. I hope it was informative, maybe entertaining, or maybe further mystifying. Who's to say? We have a live stream coming up, February 20th. We're doing several new pieces for us, which should be fun, including a jazzy cello oboe duo. So we'd love to see you February 20th on the internet.